Good morning, good afternoon, good evening. Welcome to Prince Miller Entertainment TV. Subscribe to the channel. Follow us on all our social media platforms. You're on Instagram, Prince Miller Entertainment. Facebook, Prince Miller Entertainment. Facebook group, it's Prince Miller Entertainment TV. We're also available on our Twitter handle, it's P Miller ENT. Welcome to another edition of our daily news on breaking news. And so, guys, and it's very, very interesting. And very, very interesting. So, the Supreme Court has ruled the reference to citizens' right to shelter in the country's constitution was essentially hortatory in nature, operating merely as a reminder to the government in formulating policy. Giving housing is a major issue in Zimbabwe. This judgment will impact how human rights lawyers handle cases arising from such issues in the future. The Supreme Court case was brought by the Zimbabwe Homeless People's Foundation and the Tawonga Savings Scheme. They were representing hundreds of people who took occupation of Haydon Farm outside Harare in 2000. The farm program was at its height. The farm is in Mount Habden under the Zimba Rural District Council, where upmarket residential properties are under construction as plans to relocate the capital city and the parliament there gain ground. The new occupiers built houses in 2005. They were demolished under Operation Barabatrina as part of government's drive to clear slums. The land was then acquired by the state and sold to Lengate, a property developer. Lengate in turn wants the people removed residential development to go ahead. According to the affected people still living there, they were threatened by Lengate while some have been evicted. They approached the High Court arguing that while there was no specific right to shelter or housing in Zimbabwe's Declaration of Rights, other than for children, the right to dignity necessarily incorporates the right to shelter. Without the right to shelter and to food, the promise of dignity in the Declaration of Rights would be meaningless. They asked for an order interdicting the local council and Lengate from evicting them, and they asked for service stands and for sick houses. As an alternative, they asked the local government minister, July Moyo, and lands minister, Anxious Masuka, to provide them with new land for settlement. The application was opposed by Lengate and the Zimba Rural Council, while the two ministers said the affected people were living on state land and they had no lawful authority to occupy, use, or hold it. The affected residents appeared to Supreme Court seeking a review of the matter. According to the Supreme Court, the reference to adequate shelter fell under a section that spells out national objectives to guide the state. These objectives were important for interpreting the Constitution and other laws, but they are not justiciable. The judges said no such provisions were essentially watertight in nature, rather than strictly justiciable and enforceable in themselves. This is essentially a questionable of interpretation, and the court bore in mind that the Constitution does not mean whatever we might wish it mean to mean. The Supreme Court judges added the court did not of the Constitution to ascertain the existence, nature, and the extent of those rights. The judges added Parliament in its wisdom merely made provisions for the government to take measures to actualize access to adequate shelter. It was merely something for government to bear in mind when deciding on law and policy. The Supreme Court also found the people could have sought an interdict without resort to the Constitution by opposing Lengate's application for their eviction without approaching the High Court on a constitutional basis. Although the crucial judgment was delivered last month and a very few seem to be aware of it, and according to analysts, there has been no comment from the legal, academic, or human rights communities. Top legal commentator and practitioner Musa Kika, this is not unusual. Many times people are unable to interact with judicial pronouncements precisely because detailed judgments are not handed down and put in the public domain, sometimes not early enough, he said. The result of this is that people are unable to interrogate judicial pronouncements, yet that should be a regular practice in order to ventilate the issues pronounced upon and also a way of exciting judicial accountability. According to the Constitution, the state and all institutions and agencies of government at every level must take responsible legislative and within the limits of the resources available to them to enable every person to have access to adequate shelter. Early this year, former local government minister Ignatius Chombo was arrested on allegations he used his influence to illegally grab 125 common age stands at Hayden Farm, while he also allocated himself 5 low density residential stands at Philadelphia Farm in Harare. Chombo's matter is still before the courts. So that's bad news for those people who are still at Hayden Farm. Dopamuna mega kuti msanganoka unozongurasa at the last minute unenge wakatemba. Those people were pro ZANU PF voters vakangono occupy that farm they inherited anetika vawagare papo vawaka. Then in 2005 baramba tsuna yakabva vauya vevaroa andika some vakaluza zvakawanda and some vakaramba varipo pa farm rachiroro andika. So the government end up selling that farm to Lengate Properties. They are taking so many stands andika is a low density stand. So they now want all those people that perform papo vada se varoye pass andika. So wanoenda kupi manje, you know, because there are hundreds of people who are still living on that farm andika. But according to the judgment yakazopowa ndekuti hurumende is no duty to citizens right to shelter andika. So which means kuti vanhu ava vanga kuda hurumende ivapo mastand kana kuti vanovakowo somewhere wabveyo pavari ipapo. But zviri kutonzi aiwa hurumende haine nazvo, vanhu vanga vatorova pasi. So Lengate yatone chisimba yekuti unobvisa vanhu ava wotonovakanda kuna Old Mazoe Road kuti kuna Low Magundi Road kwakuya unovasiya vari ikoko, you know. So it's one of those athletic moments, man. I just wish kuti dai hurumende yedu ka yangovatsvagirowo kokunguti vanhu havaende. But sinei vatomaswata because havasina kwekuenda. Remember kuti vanhu vakagara pafamiri since the early as 2000. Just imagine kuti it's almost like 21 years vanhu ava vachigara mufarm imomo musina masuwage, musina na maroti, musina na chii andika. So pakaipa, havasitomborina kuti vakakwanisa kuenda. So hurumende yakurasa macomrades andika vakamiramira panguva yekutora Ivhureria ndo vakuraswa because of law, because of hurumende yakatengesa land to a private developer ada kuvadzinga andika. So pakaipa, ngatitore in the comment section daily news on breaking news on Prince Miller Entertainment TV. Nakutitonge nayo nyaya iyi because it's very interesting. Wakuona housing ichinzi it's a cooperative housing kana kuti ndine musangano mukati, you need to stay away from that development or that developer or whoever. You need to stay away from those people because you never know. Some housing developments, housing projects are legit, but most of them anenge asitombori legit. Munhu yeye anenge achitongotambo nemumwe munhu ari muofisi. Once munhu ari muofisi angodzingwa basa nokuti abviswa as a minister, that housing project becomes illegal. Munenge matopa nzvimbo isingabvumidzwe anenge moshakuzoti chiko. But still council yaiziziva kuti panapa council yaiziziva, but munhu aimiramira kumberi uko asisipo, patori mumwe munhu atone interest on that land. Ndozvakangoitika ipapa pano pakaipa. This is our daily news on breaking news on Prince Miller Entertainment TV. Thank you very much for listening and watching, and remember guys to turn on the notification bell. Bless up.